वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ राहुल देव शुक्ला टेकिंग वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन न्यूमेरिकल एंड स्टेटिस्टिकल टेक्निक्स। बिफोर मूविंग अहेड विद अ न्यू टेक्निक और न्यू मेथड, प्लीज़ लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल सो दैट मोर एंड मोर सच कंटेंट ऑन अदर सब्जेक्ट्स इज ऑल्सो अवेलेबल टू यू विद इन प्रॉपर टाइम ड्यूरेशन। स्टूडेंट्स, टूडे वी आर टेकिंग रुंगाकुट्टा मैथड फॉर सॉल्यूशन ऑफ ऑर्डनरी डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन एंड वी विल सी हाउ रुंगाकुट्टा मैथड इज यूज फॉर सॉल्विंग अ ऑर्डनरी डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन। सो वी स्टार्ट नाउ। स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव फोर काइंड्स ऑफ रुंगाकुट्टा मैथड्स और वी कैन से देर आर फोर ऑर्डर्स ऑफ रुंगाकुट्टा मैथड। वन बाई वन वी विल सी द बेसिक प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी ऑर्डर मैथड। लाइक फर्स्ट ऑर्डर रुंगाकुट्टा मैथड, If any equation is to be solved, if any differential equation is to be solved, you will be given a differential equation dy by dx is equals to function of xy and you will be given initial condition y at x0 is equals to y0. That is a prerequisite. Whatever method we are going to apply, whether it is a Runge-Kutta or Picard's or Euler's or Taylor series method, it will always be given to you. Now, first order Runge-Kutta method, the basic principle or formula is very similar, or we can say the Euler's method is the Runge-Kutta's first order method. And what was the basic principle of Euler's method? Yn plus 1 can be obtained by the formula Yn plus h times function of xn comma yn. So, Euler's method is same as Runge-Kutta first order method. Okay, dear students, so we don't discuss anything further because link is given of Euler's method in the description below. You can go through the Euler's method and it will be very clear how to solve any question using first order Runge-Kutta method. Now, second order Runge-Kutta method, again you will be given a differential equation, you will be given initial condition, and now I have to find y at any given point of x. So very first we do what? We are given initial value x0 and we are given the required value of x. Now between x0 and required value, in this interval I will divide this interval in equidistant values, and then difference between two adjacent x values we will calculate as h. Okay? Now, basic principle of second order method is what? Yn plus 1. It means next approximation of y, because y0 is given to us. So, next approximation will be what? Y1. Then next will be what? Y2. Then next will be what? Y3. And how many approximations we have to follow? Like in Euler's method, it depends upon in how many intervals we are breaking the given interval x0 to x. Okay? So basic formula will be yn plus 1 is equals to yn plus 1 by 2 k1 plus k2. Here k1 and k2 we are using as two functional values. So that's why it is named as second order Runge-Kutta method, because we are using two functional values over here, k1 and k2. Now how can we calculate k1 and k2? K1 can be calculated using formula h time function of xn comma yn. And k2 can be calculated as h time function of xn plus h comma yn plus k1. So for applying Runge-Kutta method of second order, first we will calculate k1 and k2 using these formulas. Then I will put k1 and k2 values over here. Yn plus 1 is equals to yn plus 1 by 2 k1 plus k2, and then accordingly we can get successive approximation at up to the required number of approximations. Okay, dear students, the third order Runge-Kutta method, the third order Runge-Kutta method simply means now we will be using three functional values k1, k2 and k3. Again, one differential equation will be given, dy by dx is equals to function of xy, and initial condition y at x0 is equals to y0 will be given, and at any particular value of x, it will ask me the value of y. That will be the question. Again, the interval from x0 to x we will divide in number of intervals and then we will calculate equidistant value h. And third order Runge-Kutta method says the next approximation y1 can be obtained by y0 plus delta y. Now what is delta y? Delta y can be obtained by the formula h by 6 k1 plus 4 k2 plus k3. Now k1, k2, k3 are the three functional values. H we can calculate from the interval and number of intervals and the equidistant values as we have done earlier. Now how can we calculate k1, k2 and k3? K1 can be calculated as function of x0, y0. K2 is function of x0 plus h by 2, comma y0 plus k1 by 2. And k3 is what? H time function of x0 plus h plus a comma y0 plus k1. So for applying Runge-Kutta of third order, first we will calculate k1, k2, k3 using these formulas. And then k1, k2, k3 values will be put to calculate delta y. And then delta y will be put to calculate next approximation y1. The same can be repeated for calculating y2. Then y2 will be what? Y1 plus delta y. Y3 will be what? Y2 plus delta y. So that's how we will move to the next successive approximations. And now the last one is fourth order Runge-Kutta method. Fourth order Runge-Kutta method means now we'll be using four functional values k1, k2, k3 and k4. Procedure is very similar to third order. The first approximation y1, because initial value y0 is given. So first approximation y1 will be calculated as y0 plus delta y. Okay? And what will be y1? Y1 means y at x1 and x1 means x0 plus h. Again, x0 to x, the number of interval we will divide, this interval we will divide in number of equidistant values and two adjacent equidistant values, difference between these two will be h. So suppose that I have divided in two intervals. Okay, so final answer I will get after second approximation. Y1 will not be my final answer, y2 will be my final answer. So first we will calculate y1 as y0 plus delta y. Delta y will be what? Delta y will be 1 by 6 k1 plus 2 k2 plus 2 k3 plus k4. And how can we calculate k1? K1 will be h time function of x0, y0. These formulas you have to keep remember. K2 will be what? K2 will be h time function of x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k1 by 2. K3 is what? K3 is equals to h time function of x0 plus h by 2, y0 plus k2 by 2. And k4 is what? K4 is equals to h time function of x0 plus h and y0 plus k3. So for applying fourth order Runge-Kutta method, first we will calculate k1, k2, k3 and k4 using these formulas. Then we will calculate delta y, and when delta y is calculated we can get the first approximation y1 as y0 plus delta y. When first approximation is calculated in a similar method manner, the next increment in y can be computed as y2 is equals to y1 plus delta y. Again delta y will be what? Delta y will be 1 by 6 k1 plus 2 k2 plus 2 k3 plus k4. And now k1 will be what? K1 will be h time function of x1 comma y1. So in next approximation the x1 y1 is going to take the place the value of x0 and y0. So that's how we are moving to the next approximation. K2 will be what? H time function of x1 plus h by 2, y1 plus k1 by 2. K3 is what? H time function of x1 plus h by 2, y1 plus k2 by 2, and k4 is h time function x1 plus h, y1 plus k3. So all are same except x1, y1 has taken the values of x0 and y0. In very next approximation, y3 will be y2 plus delta y, and x1 y1 will be replaced by x2 y2. So that's how the similar way of approximations we will be calculating until required values of yx is not obtained. And required values of yx depends upon the number of intervals in which we are dividing the initial interval x0 to x. If we are dividing in 3 intervals, y3 will be final answer. If we are dividing in 2 intervals, y2 will be final answer. If we are dividing in 4 intervals, y4 will be the final answer. Okay, so we are summarizing here as the procedure. You will be given x0 and xn. Divide interval x0 to xn in equal distance values and find the gap h. Then compute x1, x0 plus h and find y1 using the Runge-Kutta method of fourth order. And for calculating y1, you have to calculate delta y, and for calculating delta y, you have to calculate k1, k2, k3 and k4. Then move for x2. x2 will be what? x1 plus h, and y at x2 will be y2. Again for y2, y2 will be y1 plus delta y. And then again calculate delta y. For delta y, calculate k1, k2, k3 and k4. And that will be the procedure until we don't calculate y at xn. Okay, dear students. Now, we are taking one example. For that, how to solve it? Find the value of y1.1 using Runge-Kutta method. When you are given only using Runge-Kutta method, it means you have to apply Runge-Kutta method of order 4. Okay, so that's why I am taking example only with Runge-Kutta method of order 4. Because if you can solve with order 4, you can solve with any order. Given that dy by dx is equals to y square plus xy, y at 1 is equals to 1.0. So initial values of x0 is given as 1, y0 is given as 1, function of xy is given as y square plus xy, and you have to obtain y at 1.1. So initial value of x is given as 1 and required value is 1.1. So interval 1 to 1.1, suppose that we divide in 2 intervals. So what will be the value of h? Value of h will be 1.1 minus 1.0 divided by 2, that is 0.05. Okay? So we are dividing in 2 intervals. So it means we have to follow 2 successive approximation, because x1 will be what? x0 plus h. x0 is 1. So 1 plus 0.05. So y1 will be y at 1.105. And we have to obtain y at 1.1. So y1 is not final answer. And y2 will be what? y2 will be y at x1 plus h. It means y at 1.05 plus 0.05. That is y at 1.1. And that we have to obtain. It means y2 will be final answer. So in simple way, we can say that if we are dividing in 2 intervals, we have to follow 2 approximation. And second approximation will be the final answer. Okay, now, so this question will be solved in 2 steps, because we are dividing in 2 intervals. For first step, what will be k1? Because first we will calculate k1, k2, k3 and k4. k1 formula is what? H time function of x0 comma y0. And your functional equation is what? y0 y square plus xy. So y square plus xy will be replaced by x0 y0. So this equation becomes h 0.05 into y0 square plus x0 y0. x0 y0 values are given to you. Put all the values over here and you calculate k1 as 0.1. Now we will calculate k2. k2 is equals to what? H time function of x0 plus h by 2, y0 plus k1 by 2. Now, h value is given 0.05, function of x0 plus h by 2, x0 is what? 1, h is what? 0.05, divide by 2 is what? 0.025. So x0 plus h by 2 is what? 1.025. And similarly, y0 plus k1 by 2, k1 you have calculated as what? 0.1. So y0 is 1. 1 plus 0.1 divided by 2, that is what? 1.05. Now, function of 1.025 comma 1.05. So your functional equation is what? Y square plus xy. So put all the values over here and your K2 value is coming as 0.10894. Now we will calculate K3. K3 is what? H time function of x0 plus h by 2, y0 plus k2 by 2. In the same manner, calculate K3 and K3 will be coming as 0.109637. Then we will go for calculating K4, and K4 is what? S time function of x0 plus h, y0 plus K3. Okay? And your functional equation is y square plus xy. So replace y square plus xy by these values and you will get K4 is this one. When K1, K2, K3, K4 are calculated, you can calculate delta y. 1/6 K1 plus 2 K2 plus 2 K3 plus K4, and finally you are getting delta y. Now when delta y is calculated, then I can calculate y1. Y1 is what? Y0 plus delta y. Y0 is given as 1. Delta y you have calculated. So y1 we are getting as 1.109496. Now it is my first approximation. Now the same manner I will repeat for second step to find y2. Well, for finding y2, first we will calculate k1, k2, k3 and k4. And now formula for k1 will be what? H time function of x1 comma y1. And now your x1 value is what? x0 plus h. It means 1 plus 0.05. And y1 you have calculated in first step. So putting x1, y1 in the functional equation, y square plus xy, you can calculate k1. Then you can calculate k2 by this formula. Then you can calculate k3 by this formula. Then you can calculate k4 by this formula. And after calculating all k1, k2, k3 and k4, you can calculate delta y using this formula. And when your delta y is calculated again, now you can calculate y2 as y1 plus delta y. Okay? Now y1 you have calculated, delta y you have calculated. Adding all these values over here, we are calculating y2. And y2 means what? y2 means y at x1 plus h. And x1 is what? 1.05 and h is what? 0.5. So when you have calculated y2, it means you have calculated y at 1.1, and that was asked in the question. So that's how, since we divided the problem in two intervals, so my second approximation is my desired answer. Okay, dear students, so that's how this is the Runge-Kutta method of order 4. And that's how you can apply Runge-Kutta method of order 4 to solve any ordinary differential equation. So I think you have liked the video. Now you can go for like and subscribe the channel and video. Thank you.